Welcome back. Hope you are enjoying my SAP IS-Retail tutorial videos. In this current video, we are going to see the functionality of article list. The name itself says what is an article list. It's about the list of article. Why you need an article list? You need a list of article, the article list to be shared across various systems, either through the SAP BI or among the distributed systems. To create our article list, we go to logistics, retailing, master data, article data, article list. So article list is a simple functionality. Okay, so here in this dashboard you are seeing these folders. These are all called as the hierarchy nodes. You can create article lists inside a hierarchy, but you cannot have sub hierarchies or multiple levels of hierarchies inside a hierarchy. Okay, for example, so this is the top level hierarchy, below which there is a node in which a material or article list is created and assigned at. Okay, there are two types of article list. One is the static list, another one is the dynamic list. The name itself suggests again, static list is nothing but the list of articles which you had chosen and assigned it to a list. So until unless you explicitly make any changes to that list, the list is going to be static. Whereas the dynamic list is, you are selecting the articles for the dynamic list based on some criteria, for example, based on certain merchandise categories. Okay, but after you have created the article, during that validity period, if you have created any new materials for the merchandise category which is already contained in that article list, those new materials will also automatically appear in the article list if it is a dynamic one. So these are the basic difference between a static list and a dynamic list. So when you are creating the list itself, you should define whether it is a static list or dynamic list. So let us create a new list. I go to change mode. So this is what I am saying. This is a test static list. Okay. So here you are saying what is the status of this, whether this list is the planned one or released one. If it is released and you might not want to make any changes, you can change it as released and not modifiable. Here itself you have to define whether it is a static list or dynamic list. If you, by default it is unchecked, unless you check this checkbox explicitly, the list is going to be a dynamic one by default. So let me add some. So this is a okay, so I am marking it as so let me add the materials from this merchandise category WW fit, and since this is a shared system, many other people might have used this same merchandise category, so I am restricting the material selection to my sales organization. Okay, so once you have created, you see the, so these are all the list of articles that has been added into this list. So let me add this. I want to create another material of this merchandise category WW fit and see whether it appears in this list or not. Okay, so let me save it. Okay, so let me create a new list. Test dynamic. Ideally, it should have been here. Okay, so edit selection, my merchandise category WW fit, and created for this sales organization WW01. Okay, result list. Okay, let me save this. Here you could see there is a mark against the static field to mark this list as a static list. Okay, so let us now try to create a new material slash NMM41 of this merchandise category WW fit. Make sure, like, I should have chosen the other tabs also. This is one mistake I keep doing. ND. Zero 02. Automatic negative stocks. Distribution profile. Storage location. Automatic PO, negative stocks. I want to maintain the storage location. So after we have created the article list, now we have created one more article, or one more article has been added to this merchandise category WW fit. So now let us revisit our lists. Let me drag it. So in the static list, we have the list of materials that was created already. So it started from 457, went up to 1040. Okay. But when I check the dynamic list, what happens? I drag it up. Oh, it has this 1071 below. So it is there in the test list. Sir, article list. Let me just try to see. Yes, see, you could see it is there in the article list because it is a dynamic one. The dynamic list updates the list dynamically and automatically, whereas the static list is static. So what you had added just remains in that list. Okay, so this is the functionality of, this is how you create article list. So once you have created the article list, you can interface it to the BI system or other distributed systems. Okay, so you had noticed that the article lists you are creating are for a validity period. Okay, so after that validity period, the lists move to the deleted state. Okay, so sometimes you might want to have the same list used again, only just change the validity date. Okay, so here you can check the list of, so you can see what are all the lists that are created and that had its validity period ended already. Okay, so let us move away from the test mode. So these are all the lists that have been, see, you could see that I created it on 30th of November and was valid till so and so date. So this is how we reorganize the expired article lists. Hope you found this video useful. If you found this useful, please share it with your friends, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and kindly visit my blog at www.maheshwaran.com. Have a great day.